Welcome back, guys. Here it is. It is the decisive game, the third and final between Mella and Sky Kale. This is Callus Invitational 4 play-ins, round of 8, Group A. Game 3. You guys know what the score is. Let's go. Mella on the bottom for the third and final times. Kale is on the top, and we have a very aggressive Heracross lead for Mella and a Zapdos lead for Kale, who's going to opt for an immediate substitute. Of note, the Zapdos is faster than Heracross here. Makes sense to me. There's Rock Slide, may or may not be stuck on that. Gonna go for Substitute just to check. And it's gonna be Rock Slide again. Mella is not afraid. He's gonna stay in here and keep doing this. Will Kale make a move other than Substitute this time? Yes. He'll go Baton Pass, goes to a Rock Resist. That makes sense to me. There's Jirachi. Rock Slide there, 16%. Not a huge deal. I assume this is gonna be followed up with Mel switching out. And he goes to his own Jirachi here. Substitute for Kale. This could be a sub 3 attack Rachi or a sub 2 attack Calm Mind Rachi. It's going to be Calm Mind for Mella one way or another, and it's going to be Calm Mind for Kale as well. This could get ugly depending on what attacks they both have. Does one of them have a fire attack? Do neither of them have a fire attack? Evidently Kale does not. He gets out of the way, and it doesn't look like Mella does either. The best thing he could do is Thunder. He now goes for Ice Punch. And there's a Leech Seed from Celebi, so it looks like neither Rachi potentially has Fire Punch there. It looks like Calm Mind Wish Thunder Ice Beam or Calm Mind 3 attacks, none of which are Fire Punch, from Mella. So very interesting early game here. Porygon 2 came in. That's going to get out of the way of Heracross. Brick Break there, 35%. Gotta think it's Choice Banded to do that amount of damage. Zapdos stays in for the T-Bolt anyway. And Heracross obliges with the Brick Break. Despite the resistance, that'll take him out, and the first lead goes to Mella. Here comes Celebi, and Heracross not gaining lefties as expected. Celebi on Celebi now, similar teams. They both have offensive teams. Kale's looks special base. Mella's might be closer to mixed. Leech Seed blanking on the counterpart, but he does go Calm Mind here. And Calm Mind for Mella as well. We have another Calm Mind war. Has potential to get ugly here if one of them has Baton Pass, if one of them has HP Fire. A lot of things that can go wrong here. It's a dangerous game they're both playing, and it's very hard to switch once you start Calm Minding up, because the other guy just has a clear advantage. He has all those boosts, and you don't. So once you start down this road, you're kind of obligated to keep going. And it looks like they both know that. The Calm Mind begins. It is going to be ugly. This whole entire game may come down to a critical hit, as often happens in these Calm Mind wars. But again, if one of them has HP Fire and the other doesn't, if one of them has Baton Pass and the other doesn't, the faster Celebi seems to belong to Kale. So if they do both Baton Pass, Mella will have the distinctive advantage of getting to react to what Kale Baton Passes to. So if they both did it on this turn, Mel's will happen after. And Kale does not want to run into that, so he goes for Psychic. There is Hidden Power Fire, so Mella does have it. So that's going to put the pressure on Kale. Kale will not win this blow-for-blow one-on-one. It's going to force him to Baton Pass. And Porygon 2 is going to be his target. How will this go? Substitute for Mella. Calm Mind, Hidden Power Fire, Substitute. Interesting set. Giga Drain here, so full set revealed. Is there an Ice Beam? Yes. And that will pop the sub. The mind games begin here. Does Kale go for a status move, only to have it blocked by a sub? Does he go for Ice Beam? There's Giga Drain. This could come down to a critical hit. We know that neither of these guys have the ability to Baton Pass out. Full set scene for Celebi, and then Porygon 2 just simply does not learn Baton Pass. Both guys fishing for crits here. Giga Drain and Thunder Wave. Good read for Kale. That's going to make his Porygon 2 faster here, and it's going to enable him to get a free recover off if that's what he wants to do. And Mella is going to switch out. And there is the recover, but a great play for Mella, picking up that it would be a recover turn right now and going to Heracross. That is going to get out of this Calm Mind war. Had Kale gone for another Thunder Wave right there, or simply an attack, be a very different situation. Good play for Kale. He gets the Celebi in, which easily would have died to a Heracross Mega Horn, but he gets it in on Brick Break. He makes the right call. Now Gengar comes in, and Calm Mind again. This is dangerous for both players. I'm going to pause on this turn. This is an important one. Bad things can happen here for both guys. Mella here, if he were to go for Explosion, for example, exploding on the Celebi or the Porygon 2 is very good here. Exploding into the Jirachi is not good here. On the other hand, if Gengar simply stays in and goes for, say, Hypnosis, and Kale plays around the explosion, it is really bad for Kale to get his Jirachi hypnotized here. Likewise, if it is Gengar simply going for, say, Fire Punch, just trying to get a crit or whatever on the Celebi, and he happens to Fire Punch on the incoming Jirachi, that is pretty bad for Kale. So this is a critical turn. I don't know the moveset of the Gengar. It has shown actual nothing here, but it would not surprise me if it were Boom on this kind of aggressive team, especially a lot of the time Gengar is used as bait for Blissey, tries to blow up on it so one of these special sweepers can do their thing. So they both have a lot to think about here. Of course, in real time, one or both of them probably took a minute, 2 minutes, or whatever, but in the replay, it's not going to show that, which is why I paused. But this is a crucial turn. They're both thinking about what could happen. I mean, Gengar has to worry about, does Celebi simply Psychic? That we know that he has. He has Combine, Leech Seed, Psychic, Baton Pass as the moveset. It's an easy one-hit KO plus one Psychic here. Should Mele stay in and do something other than Explosion? Or I guess Hypnosis would also block it, but Hypnosis can simply miss. Another move to consider could be Destiny Bond here. I think it's very hard for Kale to play around that here. I think if you're going to think that the Gengar is going to do something other than Boom, then I guess you just Psychic here. I think it's very hard to play around Destiny Bond. I think it's also unlikely that he has that. I think it's probably either a Wow Boom 2 attack or a Boom 3 attack Gengar. But a lot goes into this turn. Like I said, if he's anticipating Boom, he probably wants to go to Jirachi. If he's anticipating something other than Boom, he probably wants to look at simply going for Psychic. Because you don't want to Baton Pass to something, like, say, the Porygon 2, because that could just get boomed on. Though it might be tempting for Kale, if you want to go even deeper into this, maybe you do Baton Pass the boost to Porygon 2, tempting Mele to Boom, and then you immediately go to Jirachi and you eat the Boom. There's a lot that goes into this turn. We'll see what they both decide to do. It's going to be a switch to Kale. Not a Baton Pass, but a switch. And it is Boom. 48%. Takes that pretty well, actually. Porygon 2's got to be probably max on HP and defense. Heracross has been terrorizing Kale throughout the game. He has not found a good switch whatsoever. And Brick Break going to take out Swampert. That's another KO via Brick Break for the Heracross. Celebi's going to come in to check it, but it feels like Kale has consistently been one step behind. There's a poke he didn't want to see. That's a devastating turn that Kale is not going to like at all. Dugtrio comes in on a Calm Mind, swiftly takes out the Celebi. Porygon can follow up with the Revenge Kill, but that is probably a bad trade, I would think. Now, Arena Trap is going to get traced here. Dugtrio is stuck on Hidden Power Bug, and he's not able to switch either. We might go through the boring loop of a bazillion recovers until the Porygon 2 eventually decides to kill the Dugtrio. We'll see if Kale bothers going through those motions. And it looks like he will, so I'm going to switch this over to fast real quick because this might take a minute. If we're going through the full loop, I'll switch it over hyper fast. But nope, he actually does just go straight for the Ice Beam. He doesn't want to go through the loop. Don't know if I agree or disagree with that, but that's what happened. And it leaves us in a temporary 4-3 situation, quickly a 4-2 situation. That is the third kill for Heracross. Kale's team cannot deal with it. Finally, Jirachi takes it out, but that Heracross got so much real estate, taking out three different Pokemon, and we end up back where we started on turn like 2 or 3 in the Jirachi on Jirachi war. Thunder connects and paras, crucially, and a full para. Terrible turn for Kale. Terrible start to this Jirachi mirror match. And that is not the last poke that Kale wanted to have. That's a disaster. I was thinking of all sorts of things. I was thinking it was like a Raikou or a Kuhn or something. It's a Magneton. That is a disaster. That doesn't help him whatsoever. That is so useless here. I think Kale is dead in the water. Mag is not the guy that he wanted to have. I get why it's here. Celebi can Baton Pass to it. Trap Skarm get picks that way. I get it. I see what we're doing here. But that is not at all what he wants in this situation. It is so far from what he would want in this situation. Kale does hide behind a sub, but he looks pretty damn dead here. He's going to need a lot of Thunder misses Thunder has been very cooperative for Mella with that 70-30 accuracy. He's hit several of them in a row. Kale desperately fishing for a miss as he combines up. And finally, Thunder doesn't connect, but it's going to have to miss several more times in order for Kale to have a prayer to get out of this. And that is to say nothing of the fact that Mella has a poke in the back. But it is all for naught. The Thunder is going to connect and take him out. We're not even going to see the last poke. Mella is going to win the game and the series. Kale is going to be eliminated in the round of eight. Mella is going to be one step closer to achieving victory for the second time in these play-ins. He has to sit back and wait for an opponent. And that's going to be the winner of Jacob and Teclis, which of course has not played yet because this is the very first match. All right, guys, I hope you enjoyed this. There is so much going on in this tour. Like I said, if you guys want to check out these matches live as they happen, and if you want to interact with the players, there is one great place to do that. That is my Discord channel for this tournament, and the link for that is in the description. So absolutely come get involved with Callus Invitational 4, and please do consider leaving a like and or subscribing if you enjoyed this video and enjoy this tournament. So much more to come. Be on the lookout. Thank you for watching.